What if Germany had built the world's first semi-automatic tank gun in 1944? Well, they came close. Late in the war, German engineers created a mechanical assistance system for their most powerful anti-tank gun, the 8.8-centimeter KWK-43, also known in towed form as the PAK-43. It wasn't a true autoloader, but it held promise. A drum-fed mechanism that could prepare shells for faster reloading on one of the most feared guns of the war. Let's set the record straight. The so-called autoloader was more accurately a rotary loading assist system. Think of it like a revolver drum for tank shells. It could hold up to 6 88-millimeter rounds, rotating each into position near the breech. The loader would then manually ram the round into the chamber. This process reduced reload fatigue and increased rate of fire, especially in cramped vehicles like tank destroyers. One such unit was discovered by Allied forces at Hillersleben, a German proving ground. Imagine a Jagdpanther firing faster, more consistently, with less crew effort. In October 1944, German officials criticized the Panther's rate of fire compared to the Sherman. Soon after, the Heereswaffenamt began trials of a multi-loader system for the PAK-43/3. By February 1945, Krupp announced two loader drums were completed. One was mounted to a modified 88-millimeter Pak gun and sent to Hillersleben. Another was planned for the Jagdpanther, with trunnion adjustments for the drum to fit. Allied forces captured the system intact, and US engineers studied it in detail, but didn't pursue development. With the war ending, the project was archived and forgotten. So why wasn't this tech adopted? Simple: complexity, space, and timing. It added mechanical bulk and required changes to existing tank layouts. German tanks were already tight on space, and by 1945, Germany was collapsing. There wasn't time or resources for experimental upgrades. What's even more surprising? The Germans weren't just thinking about 88-millimeter guns. Studies were conducted for loading systems with 128 millimeters, 130 millimeters, and even 150 millimeters calibers. A telescoping feed rammer was designed to handle these massive shells. Krupp held meetings in early 1945 to expand the concept to self-propelled guns and ammo carriers. The war might have ended, but the ambition to automate heavy artillery had already begun. If this system had been mass-produced, Germany's heavy tank destroyers, like the Nashorn or Jagdpanther, might have become deadlier. Faster reloads, lower crew fatigue, and more sustained fire in combat. It wouldn't have won the war, but it might have changed key battles and accelerated the race toward true autoloaders. The PAK-43 loading assist is a forgotten innovation, buried by time and defeat. Not quite an autoloader, not quite a gimmick, but certainly ahead of its time. It's a glimpse of the engineering race that could have been. And had it gone just a bit further, it might have redefined armored warfare as we know it. If this story surprised you, if you'd never heard of Germany's forgotten loader tech, or if you did and you're one of the few who still cares, then here's your mission. Drop a comment. Share this video with someone who thinks autoloaders were invented in the Cold War, and subscribe for more forgotten tech, battlefield myths, and war thunder breakdowns. Because sometimes the best stories in history are the ones that almost happened.